We're tangenting. Okay, Bon Jovi, Living Proof, official lyric video. Let's go. We're tangenting.
We
What's the
didn't. Oh,
second?
wait, before we pause, pause. This is the second song from Bon Jovi we've done on a New Music Friday. The first one we did was a few weeks ago, and it wasn't actually good. We didn't really like it.
It's legendary, right? That's what it was called.
It annoyed a few. Yeah, we didn't really. It was mainly just the vocals. Like, everything else
Streamlabs
around it
has
sounded
froze
good.
still, so just be aware of
But.
that.
Yeah.
So.
But. Yeah. The main issue we had, which we're hopefully is not an issue here, was Jon Bon Jovi's vocal performance has really weakened over
Well,
the
he's
years.
fucking 95 now,
Like,
right?
and a lot of people actually just a lot of people said, "Oh my God, his voice still sounds so amazing for his age." But I mean,
Yeah, but for his age, how old is he? What, fucking
I don't
70?
know.
Gotta be.
I think he's in his like 50s or 60s. He's not old old.
50s now. Like, you can't, like,
He's
honestly,
in his,
kinda.
I think.
Honestly, Elton John, Ozzy Osbourne,
He might be
and.
60s.
Ozzy Osbourne,
Keep
Elton
in mind, Bon
John.
Jovi came up in like the mid to late 80s, keep in mind.
Ozzy Osbourne, Elton John, and Billy Joel really kind of fucked up that old voice thing for everyone else. To where they're like, they sound great for their age. And it's like, well, Ozzy Osbourne still sounds the same. Elton John, you could tell he's old, older. Billy Joel, too, a little bit, but like, overall, right? It's great. So, yeah, they kind of fucked up everybody else. Anyway, that
No,
was also.
I mean, yeah, it's the first song, not really amazing. We were hoping the
Tangent.
second
My
time
bad,
around
guys.
could
I
be
broke the
good
rules.
because we really think Bon Jovi has some classics, and you know, it's just sad that the single back
Classics is
didn't
an
really hit,
understatement. I
but
think I like every song in the top 10 on Spotify, and I know them. Classics is a bit of an understatement. This motherfucker has banger after banger after banger after banger after banger. If you look into a closet, you see hanger after hanger after hanger after hanger. That was stupid. Bon Jovi, Living Proof, let's go. This is probably going to be the best song they can come up with that has living in the title. That sounds so fucking similar.
to living on a prayer.
Well,
Well,
yeah, what the fuck? What the
yeah.
fuck?
It's gotta be intentional.
It's a talk box this time, though. It is different. It is different. Yes. Oh, I got it. I got it. No. In that song, it's his voice, and it is the same thing. But no, he's doing it. It's
Vocal production as well was in that
do you know
one.
what the, you know what that is though? It's the fucking talk thing. It's the talk box on a guitar. It's a guitar talk box.
All right.
No, it's the fucking it's the it might be the wah. I don't know. What, it's either the wah, the talk box, or the other thing. I don't know what it is, but it's one of the effects on a guitar. It's one of the cool shit. It's the talk box. Which reminds me of. First of all, shout out to Jon Bon Jovi's son. He just married Millie Bobby Brown. He married 11. Wait, pause. Not what you think. It's the character she is. He's not in trouble. It's fucking wild.
But Drake might be,
Drake's definitely in trouble because he tried to get, she okay, we'll stop, this is a dangerous
No,
area.
anyway,
Tangent, bad tangent.
I will
it
say so
reminds it
far,
sounds like
right?
Runaway.
No, but first of all,
It
right,
sounds
so
like
far,
Runaway.
the vocal is still not as good as the older stuff. However, it is better than Legendary so
Oh,
far.
it's significant. It sounds like old Bon Jovi. The melodies are
Like,
old Bon Jovi.
no, but I don't know what it was. I think it's mainly. Because one big thing I mentioned on Legendary is that I think he was going for a vocal tone that he can't do, that is not does not suit his older voice. I think here, however, he is. I think here he's maybe even he looked back and realized, oh, maybe I need to try doing a little bit of a different tone or whatever. Because this is definitely a switch up and in the right direction.
I forgot how good he could sing, by the way, until I reheard I'll Be There For You, where he does that fucking scream, and it was like, damn! So he kind of may have, he also could have fucked up his voice over the years and done a lot of damage to it. But it sounds fine. But the song sounds like, I'm saying, I don't know what it is. It reminds me of Runaway to the instrumental a little bit. This melody, you know how we listen to the Taylor Swift song on Speak Now, the Vault track, that kind of sounded like a mixture of a bunch of old Taylor Swift songs? That's what this feels like to me. It feels like a blend of a bunch of Bon Jovi songs.
Right.
Sounds good, though. Wait, wait. The smile comes out on a day. What song is that? SpongeBob.
No, the best day ever.
Best day ever. Tell me it's not. Smile comes out. The sun came up and it smiled at me. But it does. Close your eyes and tell me what you think you see. It's not that close. It's similar.
Wait, it's my life there now I'm hearing.
Yeah, it's multiple I'm hearing. That's what I'm saying.
This is a song for the brokenhearted. Dun, 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 dun. The same style. He has a line, cuts it out, an instrumental.
We'll pay attention. We'll get through the song. It did sound like SpongeBob, though.
Even the way the chorus bridges in is very It's My Life. The dun.
It's now, very similar. Yeah, it does. That's kind of what I think it was reminding me of. Sounds like if It's My Life, Run Away, and Living on a Prayer had a baby.
Yeah.
Okay, I gotta pause for the guitar solo because I want to hear hear how it flows back in without having like a stupid ass copyright issue. I'm sure this is an older audience too. Maybe it's not, but I'm assuming a lot of it's probably gonna be older audience. So I want to quickly explain this. If we let a minute of the song play consistently without a break, we can't upload this video legally because of copyright issues. Which is just, if you don't know what that is, I think she would know what that is. But if somebody doesn't know what that means, it's basically just the ownership of the song. So if we use it, it's using it illegally if it goes over a minute without a pause. Now you know, and if you already know that. And I assume, and I did something ageist, I'm sorry. You're probably smarter than me because I'm young, and my apologies. Yeah. Appreciate your generation of music, if you're older than like 30, really. The son becomes the father, and the father becomes the son. It's a never-ending... Oh, yeah. This love will last forever when I put print in the sand. It's time you understand. I'm tired of talking about someday. All the keeping, keeping on the dark days. Nothing is forgiving, it's the hard way. Right or wrong. I'm tired of talking about someday. Referring to maybe a son? That's probably what it is actually about. Bro wrote a whole ballad about how his son completed life. He's like, I had like fucking 10 songs that are like the biggest songs ever, and everyone knows our last name because of me. And you married Millie Bobby Brown. She was on Stranger Things. Either way, our family tree has nothing left to prove after what you did and I did. It's definitely both equal, right? You know, I'm Bon Jovi. I'm John Bon Jovi from Bon Jovi. Have all the biggest songs ever. And you married a lot of people's celebrity crush. Good for you. Equal achievements. Your son did better.
I'm gonna say, all right, because
it kind of grew on me. Though. While like, the chorus is actually getting caught in my head throughout this.
Here's the thing about it, right? Is it would be a tier higher if it wasn't for the fact that it's not even just. Oh, it sounds kind of like. I feel like they are cribbing from some of their older.
Did I play
hits.
That for over a minute, Dylan?
At the end.
Yeah.
Did you pause it after the guitar solo?
Did I?
If you didn't, then it did go for like a minute and a half.
Yikes. Okay, we'll continue.
If that gets blocked, you're doing it because it was you who did it.
Fuck you. No, I'm not. If I did it, you have a choice. Does this video get uploaded or not, Dylan? Have fun.
I have a choice.
You have a choice if I don't do it. Either you do it or it doesn't go on the internet. So that's fine with me. I'm going to sleep good either way. No, I didn't mean to. It was an accident.
To
be fair, anyway, we're fucking 2 hours in, Dylan.
I think it's better than the legendary for sure, right? But it's still it definitely does crib from like Living on a Prayer, It's My Life. You said Runaway as well. It definitely does. And yeah, that's the only rough part. The vocal still is a little shaky. It's not as like jumpy outy as legendary is.
If it's clearly
run down.
Easy solvent, by the way, guys. Dylan, if it really is, if I did overplay it, just mute it for the last 40 seconds. If you didn't hear it, that's why. We didn't say anything important anyway.
I can't just mute it. I'd have to download and like edit it in the software and export again.
I mean, I can, if you really need me to, I can try that. But it
that's a few hours because you forgot to pause at once, dude. That's a lot.
It is what it is, though. I mean, to be fair, you've never, it's tangent. Anyway. You gotta stop doing that, please. You know, one day my mom's just gonna slam that door open and see something she's never gonna unsee. One day that's gonna happen. It's inevitable because this is all I heard. Good night, love you. Anyway, I could have been changing or something. Yeah. Anyway, irrelevant.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah, the song's great. It actually got caught in my head. There were some parts in that, kind of like I said with, ironically enough, the last song, where it's like you could tell there was Melodyne used. Into where, like, they're bending the vocal to make it sound okay, and you can tell it's not natural. His voice definitely took some damage over time. There's no debating that. There's no lie. Like, he sounds just as good. No, he doesn't. He does not sound just as good. He doesn't. Because if the song was sung by Young Bon Jovi, it would sound...
Go back and listen to the shit he was doing in the 80s and 90s, and tell me with a straight face that the vocals here are as good as that.
Does that mean he cannot make a good song?
No, can't.
No, because Elton John does not sound nearly as good as he used to. But he's still able to make great songs if he wants to. So you don't have to have the same voice, and you just got to play into that. And he did better at it with this. They did better as a band. His vocally, he did better in the song than the last one. So it's a step in the right direction. And I thought the melody got caught in my head throughout. It does feel like a pull from his older music, but their older music. But the melody did get caught in my head the longer we listened to it. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, leave a like. If you want to subscribe, feel free because we do these all the time. We do a ton of other videos. Hundreds and hundreds of videos on our
channel. And go check out my full Like That Remix. I know I got cut off there.
Yeah, we got cut off there and forgot. Go check out his Like That Remix for sure, 100%.
Go check it out.
Go check it out. It'll be linked below. And I make music too, but that's irrelevant. It's also linked. But make sure to leave a comment telling us what you thought about the songs. Dylan, I think this is where you say goodbye.
I'm trying to say goodbye, and I say goodbye. Nah, 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 nah.